How does a company like Amazon process millions of orders on Prime Day without their system collapsing? How do they provide real-time tracking and pinpoint product suggestions all in the blink of an eye? The secret isn't magic. It's a technology called Apache Spark, the go-to data processing engine for giants like Amazon, Netflix, and eBay. In the next 15 minutes, you will learn exactly what Apache Spark is and how it works. We will break down its core architecture from driver and executor to the magic of its DAG scheduler using simple real-world analogies. By the end, you will see why Spark is the key to handling massive data at lightning speed. To really get why Spark is such a big deal, we first need to understand the problem it was built to solve. Let's put ourselves in the shoes of an Amazon engineer. Imagine it's the day before Prime Day and you have given a massive 1 TB file of last year's sales data. Your task is to find the top selling product in each country to help predict the server load. You decide to write a Python application to do this on a server. The very first problem you will hit is memory. Your server might have 64 or 128 gigabytes of RAM, but the data is 1000 gigabytes. When your application tries to load that file, it won't fit in your server's memory. The application will immediately crash. This is the fundamental bottleneck of big data that a company like Amazon deals with every single second. A single machine, no matter how powerful, has its limit. So, how does Amazon solve this? The answer is a distributed system. Instead of using one super powerful computer, they connect a group of regular computers, let's say hundreds of them, into a network or cluster. Now they can work together as a single coordinated team. Here is how that solves the problem. You can split 1 TB file into 100 smaller 10 gigabytes chunks. Each computer in the cluster gets one chunk to process. Suddenly, the task is manageable. Each machine can easily load its piece of the data into memory and find the top-selling product within its own chunk. This is the power of distributed or parallel processing. For a time, the go-to solution was Hadoop MapReduce, which solved the scaling problem but was critically slow because it constantly wrote data to physical hard disk. For a business that operates at Amazon pace, the world needed an engine that was not just scalable, but also lightning fast. And that's where Apache Spark entered the scene. Born out of UC Berkeley in 2009, Spark was designed for one primary mission: speed. The previous go-to solution, Hadoop MapReduce, was painfully slow because it kept reading and writing to the disk after every step, like a chef who runs to the pantry for every single ingredient. Spark solved this with its revolutionary approach in memory computation. Instead of running to the pantry, Spark keep everything on a massive countertop, the combined RAM of entire cluster, by keeping data in memory. It can perform operations up to 100 times faster. This is what gives Amazon the ability to deliver real-time recommendation and tracking. But blistering speed is just the beginning. Spark's true genius lies in its versatility. It's a unified engine, a complete toolkit for data professionals. For a company with many data needs as Amazon, this is a game changer. Inside the single framework, you get everything you need. Spark SQL, lets Amazon analysts use the universal language of SQL to query massive sales data set as if they were simple database tables. Spark Streaming allows Amazon to process data in real time, analyzing information as it arrives from package sensor or website clicks. MLlib, a built-in machine learning library that powers everything from the frequently bought together recommendation to fraud detection on millions of transactions. GraphX, a specialized engine for analyzing relationships, perfect for optimizing Amazon's complex global logistics and delivery routes. This all-in-one design means developers don't have to learn and maintain multiple complex systems. With consistent APIs in popular languages like Python, Java, Scala, and R to solve a huge range of problems. This combination of ease of use and raw power is why thousands of companies, including a massive portion of the Fortune 500, relies on Apache Spark. Now that we know what Spark is and why it's so critical for a company like Amazon, let's pull back the curtain. How does it actually manage a workload as massive as Prime Day? The architecture gets much simpler if we think of it as massive world-class restaurant kitchen, one built to serve millions of people simultaneously. At very top level, Spark operates on a cluster, which is just a group of computers working together. This is our entire restaurant kitchen, the space, the staff, and all the equipment, ready to handle the prime day rush. Inside this kitchen, we have a few key players. The driver program. This is the head chef. The driver is the brain of your Spark application, orchestrating the entire workflow for a task like Amazon Prime Day sales. It looks at your code and creates the most efficient plan to prepare the meal. The cluster manager. This is the kitchen manager. Spark relies on the cluster manager to handle resource allocation. For Amazon, this manager is responsible for assigning computing resources across their vast data centers. Common cluster managers are Hadoop, Yarn, Kubernetes, or Spark's own standalone manager. Worker nodes. These are the individual cooking stations. A worker node is just a single computer in the cluster with its own CPU, memory, and storage. Executors. These are the line cooks at each station. An executor is the process launched on a worker node just for your application. The head chef, the driver, gives out the work orders, and the executors are the ones who do the actual heavy lifting, processing orders data, calculating sales total, and storing the results. Tasks. These are the smallest unit of work. A task is a single action done by an executor, like find the total sales for the batch of 10,000 orders. The head chefs break the master plan down into these tiny manageable jobs. And here is the really clever part. Directed acrylic graph. Before the head chef, the driver tells anyone to start cooking, they create a master recipe. This plan outlines every single step, the order they have to happen in, and which step can be done at the same time. Spark's driver analyzes your code and builds a highly optimized DAG. This is a huge reason for Spark's speed. It figures out the most efficient way to get the job done before a single piece of the data even touched. This leads to one of Spark's most powerful features, fault tolerance. What happens if one of the server processing Prime Day orders suddenly fails? In a normal system, that could cause a chaos. But our head chef is smarter. Because they have the master recipe, the DAG, they know exactly which task failed. They can just reroute that one specific task to another executor. The overall analysis continues without any problem. This is how Spark automatically recovers from failures, making it incredibly resilient and essential for an operation like Amazon's. So, we have our high-tech kitchen. Let's see it in action. Preparing a real dish for Amazon. Imagine it's the day after Prime Day. An analyst at Amazon needs to answer a crucial business question. What were our top 10 best-selling products in North America yesterday? This means scanning through billions of orders record from just the previous day. A classic batch processing job and exactly what Spark is designed for. The analyst submits a Spark application that efficiently runs this query. In pySpark, it might look like this. Here is what the code does in brief. Create a Spark session to work with big data. Read the orders data from CSV file. Filter the North America data, group by product, sum sales, sort by total sales and pick the top 10 products. Then finally displays the final list of the top selling products. Ends the Spark session with done. Let's now understand what happens behind the scene. Once the analyst submits this application, Spark starts the driver program, which coordinates the entire job. The driver requests the resources from the cluster manager, which allocates executor on multiple worker node across Amazon's cloud infrastructure. Instead of one machine reading, each executor read a portion of dataset in parallel. Executors pull billion of the order record from Amazon's data lake, most likely stored on Amazon S3. And each executor handle its own chunk independently. Spark's data frame API make it easy to work with this structured data. Think of a data frame as massive distributed table that spread across the memory of many machines. Spark handles all the parallelism, fault tolerance, and optimization for you. The end result? Instead of waiting days for massive report, the analyst gets the accurate top-selling product insight in minutes, ready to inform the next business decision. That's how Spark delivers fast, scalable batch processing, even at Amazon scale. If you are finding this breakdown helpful and want to get hands-on, make sure you hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications. Our next two videos are pySpark tutorial for beginners series. First, we will guide you through building your first data pipeline. After that, we will show you how to master pySpark data frames and essentials transformation. You won't want to miss that. So, we have covered the core engine. But the Spark story doesn't end there. It's important to know that Spark isn't just a single tool, but a whole suite of powerful libraries built right on top of the core. We have already talked about Spark Core, which handles the fundamental tasks, scheduling and fault recovery, the foundation of the entire Amazon data operations. Then, we have a Spark SQL, which we saw in the action analyzing Prime Day sales. And for real-time needs, there is Spark Streaming. This component is designed to process live data as it flows in form of source like clicks on Amazon website or update from their delivery trucks. The true power here is that Spark provides a unified stack. You don't need to stitch together separate system. For example, Amazon can use Spark Streaming to analyze your clicks in real time as you browse their sites. Then using Spark SQL and MLlib in the same application, they can join that live data with your purchase history to generate a personalized recommended for you list instantly. This is unified approach simplifies development and allow Amazon to build sophisticated end-to-end data pipeline on a single powerful platform. So, let's bring it all together. We asked how giants like Amazon handle flood of data, and we found the answer is Apache Spark. It's a unified analytics engine that gets incredible speed for in-memory processing, making order system looks like they are standing still. We saw how its resilient restaurant kitchen architecture with the driver and the head chef and the DAG as the master recipe deliver both the speed and fault tolerance needed to power Prime Day. Ultimately, Spark is the engine that turns massive data into real-world value for Amazon. From batch analytics on the sales to real-time product recommendation. And if you are ready to apply these concepts, our next series is for you. We are launching a pySpark tutorial for beginners, where we will start by building your very first data pipeline and then follow up by showing you how to master pySpark data frames and all the essential transformations. It's the perfect next step. Thank you for watching. If you learned something new today, give this video a thumbs up and let me know in the comments what other big data topics you would like to see explained. See you in the next one.